eventually going to get cut, yes. But the 2x4s are basically for
the interior walls.
We want oak exterior
walls.
Makes sense, right?
Okay, so, we don't argue here. We don't complain. We just do what we like to exercise.
I want all those 2x6s cut. Because if we can throw two walls up today, which is what I would really like.
Clark, I agree, but you know what? Making so much talk about the problem. But we've been moving these things for no reason.
Chooses, but let's say we were moving 2x4s and I look down and I see Ben's moving 2x4s. I would just say, hey guys, stop moving the 2x4s, move the 2x6. No. But guess what?
When you look down, I was organizing the job.
It's not, but
how many times I was organizing the job when you look down?
Organizing what? You already told me that you're moving 2x4s.
Wait, no, if we don't move those, you're telling me if we don't.
So then what were you organizing?
If I was organizing moving 2x4s.
You're organizing moving the 2x4. Okay, we're organizing moving 2x4s.
There's other things that just
all right, you know what? I don't want to waste any more time, okay? Let's move to 2x6.
Okay. Mark knows, I know, there's way too much guys here. Right. Whatever.
I like having the guys out here. I want the guys to have experience doing everything. And we want the guys to be good at everything too. And
you're training them right now. You're training them.
That's right. They need to have their hands on everything, right?
I don't even know why you brought Richie. Remember the last time? This guy, he's going to get hurt. Because can't handle Richie today. You know what I mean? Like me, I got to get a lot of work done here. Just keep an eye on him. That's what I'm saying, Mark. Keep
he's
an eye.
You're going to be fine. Me, I hold Richie. You mind your crew. Let me take care of my people.
Yeah,
all right?
I'm just saying.
Because we're Marlin.
He's working.
Is he?
He's doing enough things up there right now. He's working.
All right, good.
All right. And I end up doing all the dirty work, always. Guys are building houses. I'm moving on. You know? This is my life. Can't complain.
A lot of times, we might bring an extra man or two on a job, right? And Dwayne doesn't like that because he's a freaking cheap bastard. And that's just the truth. The guy's like, do we need them? I'm like, no, we don't technically need them. However, what happens when you let man stay home? They get bored, they look another job, they go find somebody else, and then when you really need them, you're in a bad deal. You have nothing. Right? Alright, so more times, if we have a man working Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, and if I don't need them Thursday and Friday, I might just say, you know what? Just bring them. Finish the week. You know what I'm saying? That's me.
And you know what's gonna happen after that? Mark's gonna call me and ask me, Dwayne, you have $100 in your pocket? Because I'm broke. I'm broke, I have no money. You know how many times you get phone calls? Guess what, Mark? Dwayne, you have $100? Because I have no money. Bills are come up. See me? You know?
Perfect. So you know what you do then? File a help wanted poster, put it on Kijiji somewhere, and hire guys and ask for temporary work, part-time, and put out what you need. More times? We're hiring family, people who we know need to work. And you can't just hire a man and then let them go. If you want an employee, strictly business, then do that. But my brethren, my family, I can't just give them work 2 days and then make them stay home.
I'm a family guy too. Like, let's not get crazy about this family
talk. That's perfect. So if you have an employee that you want to just take and say, hey guys, no more work. Okay, then those guys, you can send them home. But if we hire friends and family,
I don't send guys home. I don't bring guys to work. I won't send them home. If I bring them here,
same thing.
I'm not bringing them with me.
Same thing.
Because if I bring them with me, I'm not making no money. They're not making no money. It doesn't make no sense.
No, they're making a little bit.
A little bit, and so am I.
And you know what?
Very little.
If you have a little faith in life, and if you invest a little bit into the guys, okay, they might be able to return and yield a little bit of profit, and you might even enjoy that.
Might. Can you believe 10 years in, we're saying we might make a profit? 10 years in, we might make a profit here. Oh my gosh, this is a problem. Might, after 10, 15 years in the business, scars everywhere, and we might make a profit. I don't go back to that. Because honestly, does it make sense? Can you believe?
You can put me in an $18 million house, and I'm trimming with the best of them. And this is the difference between me and Dwayne. You can put me in any environment, I adapt fast.
Room for room.
Dwayne had a room, Mark had a room.
Yes.
Who would win?
Mark.
Mark would win.
Mark would win.
Who would be over budget or under budget?
Mark would probably be over budget.
Yeah.
Dwayne would probably be under budget. But the room would be nice.
If there's a room by room challenge between Mark and I, It gets very sticky because there's always a lot of rules.
Yeah. A lot of times, I'm team Deutsch. Don't tell
team Deutsch. Why though? Who's the more skilled craftsman?
I'm not gonna lie, is Mark.
You get points for neatness, speed, agility, and how nice you look when you're doing it. Being serious, you have to look nice. You can't just be slow. You gotta look nice. Your posture has to be good. He cheats.
We had a drywall competition one time with his screw, like, I don't know, a wall. I'm screwing every 16 inches. This guy's screwing every 2 feet. It's not a pass. You know what I mean? He's done first, but it's not a pass.
He's the more skilled craftsman. Mark.
Me versus Dwayne. Any room, in any house, anytime, anywhere, any time frame, any budget. And I'm taking it down. Gold medal. So we're building a house that is eventually going to be 3 inches too high. And if the surveyors come and actually do their job properly, they're going to say this shit's too high. Cut it down. Right? So
they won't really say cut it down.
They're going to say it's too high. Do something.
3 inches too high, they're going to care.
There are laws on how high you can go. Okay? And we don't need a problem. We don't need the stress. So what we're going to do is we're going to pre-cut everything 3 inches. All right? So that when we go up, no one can say nothing.
116.
Here's the thing though. The problem is these guys have to cut the stuff properly. Because this the stuff that we have to pre-cut on the manufacturer, laser level. Okay? Now we have these flicking fazulus trying to cut it by hand, and they better do a flicking good job or it's going to be a flicking problem. You guys already know, all the floors have to be cut down, so we can't even build that wall unless we get our studs cut.
Mark, honestly, there's
we have hundreds and hundreds of studs cut.
Probably like 400 studs cut right now. We've been sending them up all the while. Look at the pile.
We've
been sending studs up. Like,
that's 400 studs?
It's like 400. Huh? Look at how we
Richard, why are you shooting down on the freaking studs?
Look how high the man is on the studs. I've been cutting studs like crazy. What do you want? How much more studs do you need?
We need lots of studs.
Mark, I've been cutting non-stop.
Rico, how much studs do you need for those two walls?
Right here.
I've been cutting like crazy. Honestly, we're done half the pile. We're done half the pile. I'm cutting non-stop. My production is crazy down there.
All right, we can do this.
Dude.
I can do this. We told them to cut it off 2 3/4 inches. I got studs that are not cut 2 3/4 inches, and that's a big problem for our wall.
You're going to from that side, shoot from that side so you can see their faces. Yeah.
Richie, in on this!
Yeah.
Richie, in on this! Richie!
Hey, where are you? Try to look the easiest way out. Come in, man.
Hold on. Yeah, hey.
He's at his face. Hold up!
Easy. Don't worry.
Yo, Rocky! Can you hand him one at a time? Yo, Rocky!
Yeah.
Grab 2 studs at a time! You're fucking big! You're not a little kid! What are you doing? 2 studs at a time, bro! Yo, bro, 2 studs at a time! You're not a fucking kid! What are you talking about? About 1 stud at a fucking time. Think I'm gonna be here the whole day?
Richie!
Yeah.
You good, man?
Good, man.
Where are you going?
Huh?
Where are you going? Dinner? Can't take it.
All right.
Look at more.
But I knew from the beginning of the day he was going to make it.
Yeah,
Ricky, you know, you're too hard on the man.
Me? It wasn't me.
What happened?
He already told us what happened.
What happened?
I look a bit hard on him.
Rigo was a little hard
on him. I didn't even scream at him.
A little aggressive.
You know what?
I didn't even scream. I just said get to work.
Listen. I'm not hard on your guys.
I even said to
I'm
him.
Not hard on your guys.
Yeah. You know what? Today was an all right day. Okay. We got what we wanted done. We got the floor done. We got 2 walls up. We fixed the architect's problems. We fixed the builder's mistakes. Okay, so that's a good day.
All I ask is on a good productive day like today, you can cut the studs at 2 3/4 inches.
In my defense, I didn't cut any studs today. I measured all the studs and gave them to my guy.
Same problem.
But you're the one that marked this. So he's only cutting where you're marking.
He's just cutting lines.
So at the end of the day,
450 studs that came up. He missed a couple.
I would have got every single one right.
No, but he missed a couple. It's not my fault.
You know what?
Hey, Mark. Dwayne, how you doing, guys?
Good.
Another long Monday.
How's it going, Bert?
Long Monday.
Yeah.
We're making progress, so I'm here.
Yeah, lots of work.
Yeah.
Like it?
The wife just sent me in. Hey, she wants me to check up on you guys.
Great.
Yeah. So, what's going on?
Long day.
Looks good to me. Looks fine.
You want to come check
out? Sure, I'd love to look at it.
I actually want to ask you a couple questions about this stuff.
I love looking at toilets.
I'm going to finish scraping this wall that he actually messed up.
You know what? Up here, the only thing I noticed when I came in was this right here, this little lip. You know? And
I
guess you're going to do something with that, eh?
Yeah, don't worry, we'll fix that up for you, no problem.
Six and a half.
All those are going to be 6.5.
Basically.
I'm just saying, why do customers have to come and point out stupid stuff? And then we look like, I don't know, maybe if anyone had any common sense, they'd say we hired the wrong fucking guys.
Maybe, because I'm busy doing other things, I haven't talked to them.
Yeah, I know, busy.
What do you mean? You see, Brick, you see, been here for a couple days. You're not supposed to be there first.
I don't care that it's wrong. I care that there's no plan to fix it, and obviously it's not in the budget.
The funniest thing is,
it's not in the budget.
It's the first time I've even addressed it. What do you mean a plan? Have you planned something for this wall? Have you planned something for this?
Listen.
Have you planned something for that? Have you planned something for this?
No,
you talk about plans. There's a thousand things that have to be planned.
That's right.
They talk like that all the time. They're just kind of loud.
You see the mistakes. You see all the
no, they weren't fighting.
You need to do.
I'm a little tight for time, so I'm just going to go. Great to meet you, man. I'll see you again soon.
No, we've been in this business for long enough. You know you can't plan everything. There's going to be.
But it's obvious. Okay, you got a staircase that's weird with no rails, with a clearance that I don't know. Freaking my daughter can't.
There's a ton of obvious things, Mark. They're gonna have to be addressed. It's not even a big issue. It's an hour issue. I'm not the inspector here. Okay, I'm a guy who's coming here to do some cosmetics, some brick, paint, something like that. Now you're talking about head clearance and stuff. I don't got the rule books in life. I don't got all the rule books. I go off my drawings and I do what I gotta do.
Yeah. He never checked it. He never thought to check the freaking head clearance. He never thought to check the head clearance. Like, come on. Honestly? Really? Really? I can't. Honestly, I don't have time. I got lots of stuff to do. Call me when you're serious about life. I can't. Wait, this is ridiculous.